Dr. G. Arumugam and Dr. Mohammad Tugnovic. Dr. M. Tangaraj and Dr. Xavier Thiludurai. Ms. Gandhi Sivakumar. Achieving good performance is a journey, not a destination. In this moment, we look back and assess the performance of our conference team. We'll feel proud of this moment of releasing our conference proceedings. We request our Honorable Vice Chancellor to release the conference proceedings, which will be received by our respected chief guest, Dr. Mohammad Tugnovic. Thank you, sir. Truly a proud moment for all of us. We request our Honorable Vice Chancellor to release the conference proceedings CD, which will be received our beloved resource person, Ms. Gandhi Sivakumar. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, dignitaries. We have among us a person who has set high goals, striving for its attainment, and thus inspiring everyone around him. Whether he intends or not, he leads by example. He is a person who has made success as his habit. He is none other than our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. P. P. Chelladurai.
Distinguished chief guest of this international conference and the representative of the University of Maribor, Dr. Mohammad Tugnovic, Institute of Informatics, Faculty of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science. The other two dignitaries seated on the dais and one of the proud alumni of the Madurai Kamaraj University, Dr. Xavier, Vice President, Capgemini Systems, Bangalore, Mrs. Gandhi Sivakumar, Architect, IBM Research Australia, and the dynamic chairperson and the head of Department of Computer Science, Dr. G. Arumugam, who is also the convener of this international conference, and the dynamic upcoming professor, Dr. M. Tangaraj, the co-convener of this international meet, and the UPE coordinator, and one of the senior professors of this university, Dr. Ramuji, and Professor Ramaswamy from the Department of Computer Application, and Professor of Computer Science from the Kodaikanal University, other faculty members of the School of Informatics Science and Communication, and teachers from the sister universities, and my dearest students. Today is a very, very happy day for me and also for the university, in the sense that the Department of Computer Science has rightly come forward in organizing this timely program in order to update our knowledge in one of the vital areas of computer science and information technology, that is big data analytics and intelligent technologies. In fact, on this occasion, while declaring open this international conference, I place on record my deep appreciation for Professor Armugam and his team of faculty for having displayed a tremendous enthusiasm and energy, wisdom and knowledge in demonstrating their commitment to developing the Department of Computer Science and also the student community in studies in the Department of Computer Science of this Madurai Kamaraj University. Friends, as the Vice Chancellor, I am to make it very clear that as on date, the environment in the university campus is very, very conducive for all of you to think afresh, all of you to come forward to take up new initiatives for development in the frontier areas of knowledge and also for cutting edge research in the chosen areas of national importance and social relevance. Of course, the Madurai Kamaraj University has recently was able to convert all the conventional 82 classrooms into smart classrooms, providing interactive whiteboard, and now the faculty are empowered to empower the student community to have access to Google. Google, like an eagle, will enable you. It will make you feel that you are more capable these days. In the earlier years, yesteryears, there was no such facility available either for the teachers or for the students. And now, every bit of information that you may need, either for your higher learning or for your research programs, you can call out from the thousands of knowledge websites made available in the Google. So Google is now the enabler. And your professors are the enablers. Of course, they are your leaders. And I must, on this occasion, salute the teaching fraternity, taking the clue from Alexander the Great, the youngest world conqueror, who once said that, "I am indebted to my father for my living, but I am indebted to my teacher for my living well." So it is the teachers as knowledge leaders and technology transmitters and promoters play a crucial role in enabling the student community to learn what is needed and to stand on their own legs. Because Swami Vivekananda, the spiritual father of the nation, rightly said that one of the purposes of higher learning is to enable the learner, I mean the student, to stand on their own legs. If one is to stand on his or her own legs, the only way out is to develop independent and critical thinking. Knowingly or unknowingly, in our country, the school system doesn't promote independent thinking. It doesn't promote critical thinking. And every emphasis is laid on rote memory. One has to muck up. One has to reproduce in verbatim whatever is studied from the book. And therefore, this country is not able to produce scientists and technocrats who are capable of making inventions and innovations. It is happening here and there, but the size of our human power, the mind power is so vast. The human power available in this country is so vast. We have tremendous potential. But fortunately or unfortunately, because our system, the learning system, is not one of thought process, we are not able to, you know, go up, 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 just like an eagle, which is able to fly at the highest altitude. And we shall follow not only the Google, but also the eagle. The researchers and the students in the computer learning domain shall think about inventing something new, innovating something new, and we should also be interested in knowledge transfer and technology transfer from our university laboratory, from our university library. Knowledge shall be transferred to the village community. And we have adopted 421 villages. When our students and teachers visit the villages at least once in 15 days, you will be in a position to transfer your knowledge to the young people, the children in the villages who have to know a little bit of knowledge about the computer application and the computer system, because now a life without a computer is a life without memory, or a man without a memory. So computer has come to stay. Communication technology has come to rule us. So when these things are now being made practical, every effort shall be made to transform every mind in our institutions in such a way that they will be more productive and they will help the society to go for more prosperity. And therefore, only friends, way back in 1943, when Winston Churchill, the then Prime Minister of England, was invited by the Harvard University to deliver the convocation address there, when the first, Second World War was going on, and he made a prophetic remark that the empires of the future will be the empires of the mind power. It's not the physical power. So now, the mind power has to be triggered with the computer system, with the computer engineering, and with the help of the computer analysis of the data and all, because there is an explosion of data. And the data has to be analyzed and critically arranged so that your data, the verified data, will become the knowledge. And verified knowledge will become wisdom. So therefore, the final, the ultimate purpose of the education is to move from information to data, from data to knowledge, and from knowledge to wisdom. And that's the final thing. So now, the Madurai Kamaraj University is in its relentless march towards the attainment of excellence, the attainment of eminence. I am certain that this international conference on big data analytics and intelligent technologies will be a feather in the cap of not only that department, but also in the Madurai Kamaraj University. And I congratulate on this occasion the experts from Australia, the expert from Slovenia, and the University Maribor, and our old, you know, student, Dr. Xavier, the Vice President, Cap Gemini Systems. I would be too glad if Professor Armugam and his team, particularly Professor Thangaraj, will come forward to make use of their services to organize placement program for the entire students in studies in the Department of Computer Science and also in the Department of Computer Application. So when we have such great people connected with us, not only as our guest speakers, but as our own pride alumni, I think it will be very easy for the department to do some big campus mela program so that our students will be the beneficiaries and the name and fame of the department shall spread across the globe. And computer science department, which is interested in information technology, which is interested in data analytical research, is in an advantageous position to make use of such an environment for the better tomorrow. With these few words, I place on record my appreciation for the entire faculty members in the Department of Computer Science and the student community, and also the resource persons who have come from all the way to interact with the participants in this two-day international conference on big data analytics and intelligent technologies. Thank you all.